Elements of financial statements. These are going to be one of the first things you memorize and practice during your first accounting semester. It is very important that you get familiar with the five account types that we are going to discuss today, because they are going to come back over and over and over again, not only in this semester, but in future semesters. So officially, there are 8 to 10 different account types, depending on whether or not you include gains or losses. However, as an introductory accounting student, you are really only going to be dealing with these five right here. Now, keep in mind, we're going to go over a few different examples of each. Really pay attention to those definitions so we can try applying them later in the video. Now, assets, simply put, are those items that you own. But more officially, they are future economic benefits. For example, if I own a television, that has a future economic benefit. It's something I own. That is an asset. Another example of an asset would be cash. That obviously has a really nice future economic benefit. I get to spend it. Another example would be accounts receivable. Now, accounts receivable are monies that are owed to us. So that has a future economic benefit. In the future, we are going to be receiving some cash. Other than that, you can remember that assets can include both tangible things we can touch and intangible items. Things are just kind of thought up. For example, patents, exclusive right to create and sell something. That is a kind of a concept, an idea. It's a legal right, that patent, but that is still an asset. It's something we own. It has a future economic benefit to us. Now, the second one on this list are liabilities. Now, liabilities, simply put, are things that we owe. However, they are considered future economic sacrifices that we will be making. One of the most popular liabilities that you are going to see is likely going to be accounts payable. Now, accounts payable, kind of like the opposite of accounts receivable, accounts payable are monies that we owe to other parties. So if I go into a vendor and I say I would like to purchase $1,000 of supplies and I say I will pay you later, we'll have two things there. We'll have supplies, that's something we own, that's an asset, and then we will have accounts payable. That's what we owe. There's our liability. Other examples of liabilities would be things like mortgage payable. Those amounts that we owe on a mortgage for a building, that would be a liability as well. So you might be seeing a trend here that payable is kind of like a nice key word to see if something's a liability. But keep in mind that not all liabilities will have payable at the end of it. So we'll see some examples of that in the practice slide. Now, equity are the owner's interest in a company. Typically, if you have a proprietorship, an individually owned company, equity will just be amounts that the owner has invested within the business. If we're dealing with a larger company like a corporation, those will be common stock, preferred stock, paid in capital, anything that really signifies monies that were put into the company to kind of invest in it. Revenues are amounts that we have earned. And typically, sometimes it can even have a sacrifice or future sacrifice arise from it. But keep in mind, it's very basic the way we're defining this one at this point. But revenues are amounts that we earn. And expenses are money spent or costs incurred to generate those revenues. So let's keep one thing in mind before we go on to this practice. Some of these words have some other terms that can apply to them. For example, another very common way of saying equity is capital. So you're going to want to know that both of those are interchangeable. And the same thing with revenues. Another term for revenues would be income. So with these new terms, we can kind of create a nice little acronym here. ALCIE, ALCIE. So that's kind of a nice, easy way to remember your five accounting terms. So let's go on to this next sheet and let's practice actually applying those to see if we can figure out what is what. So let's start with this first one. Please feel free to pause the video so you can kind of practice it and think on your own. The first one here, accounts payable. We're seeing that keyword payable. So what would accounts payable be? That would be our liability. Let's go ahead and put that in there. So remember, whenever you're seeing payable, that is a really great keyword to know that, okay, that's a liability. That's a future economic sacrifice. That's something I owe. Now, how about cash? Now, cash is something we own. Nice and simple, that would be an asset. Now, notes receivable. So remember, we're seeing that word receivable again. We talked about accounts receivable on the other page, but what about notes receivable? Now remember, this means that we are going to be receiving money for a note in the future. And if you're not familiar with what a note is at this point, typically the most common type of note that we see are car notes. When you purchase a car and you finance a portion of it, you're going to have a car note. So in this case, though, we are going to be receiving the money for a note. So we're kind of on the opposite end from that kind of scenario. So for notes receivable, we own the right to receive money in the future. So this one is going to be another example of an asset. Now, equipment. Now remember, think about what equipment is. It's something that we own. Now, what were things that we own? Assets. Let's go ahead and bring that one over as well. Okay. Now, here's a fun one. Kathleen Mooney Capital. We have a little bit of a clue in there. Capital. So which one would this be? This would be a capital account. Now, typically this arises when, in this case, Kathleen Mooney, the owner of this proprietorship, invests money or contributes money to her company. That's her interest, her capital within the company. So that right there is our equity or our capital example. Supplies expense. Yes, there's a great key word here. You see expense, so it is an expense in this case. However, before we go any further, I just have to warn you that just because it says expense in there, it doesn't guarantee that it is an expense. And we'll see an example of that a little later on. Now, building. This is something we own. It has a future economic benefit. And it's even tangible. So this one is another example of an asset. We're seeing a lot of assets here. Prepaid rent. Now, typically when students first think of rent, it automatically comes to mind, well, rent is an expense. And you're right, rent typically is an expense if the payment we are making is for the current month. However, in this case, we are prepaying it. So think about what that prepaying would do to this type of account. What does prepay mean? It means that we're paying something in advance. So we have a future economic benefit. So think of it this way. Let's say that you pay $500 for your rent for this month. You're using it up this month. Does that have a future economic benefit? No. In that case, that would be an expense. However, what if for some odd reason you decide to pay for rent for 12 months instead of just the 1 month. Well, maybe the 1 month would be an expense, and some textbooks do automatically expense that first month. But the more common way of doing that is to take the whole 12 months and to put it into a prepaid rent account. So this prepaid rent has a future economic benefit. So what are future economic benefits? Assets. Now keep in mind, once the time actually passes, essentially once you live in your apartment or your home or in your business space for the amount of the time that you actually paid for, as those months go by, then that prepaid rent is going to become an expense later. But we'll talk about that more once we get to adjusting entries. Now, fees earned. Now these are fees that we have earned. And this is a really simple way of thinking about revenues. There's actually some new information that has come out by the Financial Accounting Standards Board that makes this a little bit more complicated. But at this introductory level, we can just kind of think as these as things that we earned. Well, what are things that we earn? That would be our income/revenues. What about copyrights? Now think about the items on your list. If you ever get stuck on one, think, okay, well, assets are things we own. Liabilities are things we owe. Capital is the owner's interest in the company. Income are things that we earn. And expenses are money spent or costs incurred to generate revenue. So it's not quite an expense. It's not income. It's not the owner's interest. It's not something we owe, but it is something we own. So that copyright, that would be an asset. Now, how about here? We have office equipment. Over here, we dealt with equipment previously, and we determined that was an asset. Would it really change at all over here for office equipment? And the answer is no. Office equipment is the same thing as equipment. It all depends on how the company decides to make their account titles. And we'll get into a chart of accounts hopefully in another video so you can kind of see how this all plays out for an actual company. Now, miscellaneous expense, we see a nice keyword here. It's nothing out of the ordinary. So yes, this one is nice and easy. This one is an expense. Now, common stock, remember, this is one of those situations that you're probably not going to run into right away, depending on what textbook you're actually using for your course. But common stock are essentially owner investments in the company. The company issues the stock to stockholders, which are owners, in exchange for cash or other assets or services. So this is another example of a capital or equity account. Now, service income. Now, service income, we're seeing kind of a little keyword here, and you are correct, it is income. These are basically amounts that we earned for providing services. So this would be an income account. Okay, unearned fees. This is a fun one. Typically, when students see this word fees right here, they think, okay, well, I dealt with fees earlier, it was an income. However, this is a little different. Remember, we're using kind of a cheat here. We're using that keyword, earned. Now, if these fees are not earned, what does that mean? One of my favorite examples of this is if I call someone up to come fix my garage door and I pay them $500 in advance, he gets to receive that cash. He gets to say, okay, now I have cash, but what else does he get to record? That other piece that he gets to record are unearned fees. So what is that unearned fees? That is a service that he owes. So that's a future economic sacrifice. That's something he has to do. He hasn't earned that cash that I gave him yet. He has to do something further. So there's those unearned fees. So what are things that we owe? Those are liabilities. Let's go ahead and put that one in. That's a challenging one. It's a good test question. What about supplies? Now, supplies are things we own, nice and simple. There's an asset right there. Accounts receivable. We talked about receivables a little bit up here with notes receivable as well as on the other page. So those are another example of assets. Now, here's a good one. Prepaid expenses. Now, notice it has a few things here. It has that word expenses in here, which that makes you think automatically it might be an expense, but it also has prepaid. You're talking about prepaid over here. Now, remember, if an expense is prepaid, it's not an expense right now. It's an asset for now. Once we use up that future economic benefit, then it becomes an expense. Okay, how about here? Mortgage payable. We see a nice little keyword. Payable. Yep, that is a liability. And this last one's fun. Kathleen Mooney drawing. This is a very special type of account. Typically, what we see here is a lot of students have a lot of difficulty with this one, but this one's special. What it does is it offsets something, and we'll see that later on what it offsets. But whenever something offsets another account, that is going to be called a contra account. And what it does is it offsets capital. So in this case, this drawing is going to be a contra capital account. So when you see that, keep in mind that's not just a capital account, it's a contra capital. And once we get into debits and credits, you're going to see why it's so important that you remember that this isn't just any typical capital account. Okay, so please feel free to review this video a few times, stop it, pause it, see how many of these you can understand and do correctly. If there's any that give you a little bit of trouble, try kind of rewinding a little bit and listening to the explanation, because that will definitely help. Okay, happy studying. Good luck.